There's a lot of bad information going around about Cyril Pharrell, so I wanted to clear up some stuff in two videos. In this one, we're going to look at just one thing. Did Cyril Pharrell intentionally let the Lannister guards live since he's a faceless man, and faceless men don't kill for their own purposes? Nope, he killed them, at least in the canon he did. It's pretty gnarly, check it out. So there are five Lannister guards. They had chainmail over their chest and arms, and steel cod pieces sewn into their pants, but only leather on their legs. Their hands were bare, and the caps they wore had nose guards, but no visor over the eyes. Let's pretend you're playing a video game. Cyril Pharrell, he's lightly armored, just boiled leather. Sir Meron Trance, heavily armored, plate and mail, and the Lannister guards had on medium armor. And keep in mind, Cyril's sword is not just a wooden sword. There's a hollow inside of it that is filled with lead, so it's pretty heavy. It can do some serious damage. The first guard tries to walk by Cyril before the fighting began, but Cyril rings him on his helm and says, "I am Cyril Pharrell, and you will now be speaking to me with more respect." So the guy goes to draw his longsword, and Cyril smashes his hand, breaking his fingers. That dude then pulls out a dagger, so we're going to call him Dagger Man. Meanwhile, the other four guards unsheathe their longswords. Now you're in for a treat, the same treat that Arya got. They approached him from three sides, but he did not wait for them to reach him. He spun left. Arya had never seen a man move as fast. He checked one sword with a stick and whirled away from a second. Off balance, the second man lurched into the first. Cyril put a boot to his back and the red cloaks went down together. So we're going to call these two guys Fallen Man 1 and Fallen Man 2. The third guard came leaping over them, slashing at the Water Dancer's head. Cyril ducked under his blade and thrust upward. The guardsman fell screaming as blood welled from the wet red hole where his left eye had been. That's pretty much the end of this guy. We're going to call him One Eye. Fallen Man 1 and 2 start getting up, but Cyril kicks one of them in the face. We're going to call him Face Kicked. And Cyril snatched the steel cap off Fallen Man 2, so he's now Helmetless Man. As Cyril does this, Broken Fingers Dagger Man stabbed at him, but Cyril caught the thrust in the helmet and shattered the man's kneecap with his stick, so now he's Broken Leg Man. The last Red Cloak finally joined the fight. We'll call him Last Man Standing. Last Man Standing shouted a curse and charged, hacking down with both hands on his sword. Cyril rolled right, and the butcher's cut caught the helmetless man between neck and shoulder as he struggled to his knees. The longsword crunched through mail and leather and flesh. The man on his knees shrieked. So Helmetless Man is now Dying Man. You can't debate that. He got a sword down through his neck and shoulder. That's no bueno. Before Last Man Standing could wrench his blade free, Cyril jabbed him in the apple of his throat. The guardsman gave a choked cry and staggered back, clutching at his neck, his face blackening. In other words, he's choking to death. So did Cyril kill anyone? Well, he stabbed one through the eye, he kicked one in the face, he broke one guy's knees, and one of them is presumably dying from the attack that Cyril dodged, because that sword crunched through mail and leather and flesh between his neck and his shoulder. And last but not least, Cyril smashed the last guy's Adam's apple, and he's choking to death. So yeah, Arya was right. As Sir Meron Trant drew his longsword, Arya noted that five men were down, dead or dying. It doesn't mean Cyril can't be a faceless man, because Jochen kills more than three people in the show, and way more than three in the books. But I just wanted to clear this up. In the canon, Cyril personally kills at least one of the Lannister guards that attacked him. Alright, I'll talk to you.